has a different opinion. He says that in this country where there is poverty and large financial leakages, this scheme might not work. So, Safi, take it here.
Good evening, judges and friends. I'd like to first start by asking a question. Why are we now talking about direct or conditional cash transfers? Why are we now going to talk about direct or conditional cash transfers? The primary reason why the government is wanting to looking into this concept is for two reasons. One is to address leakage, and second is to address the issue of targeting. And the secondary issue or the objectives, what can be achieved through these cash transfer mechanisms, is financial inclusion and income empowerment. And I, my friends, believe strongly that this cash transfer, direct cash transfer particularly, would not address any of these primary or secondary objectives. So I would like to look at this cash transfer concept in three different angles or three different divisions. The first one is, why do you do cash transfers? First one can be for contingencies. For example, there is a widow. There is a death of a primary breadwinner in the family. So you give cash transfers for that. Now you cannot give a condition. Now you can say, I will give you tokens. The cash transfer has to be immediate. So this is first category, which is for contingency. The second category I would like to look at is for subsidies. So for kerosene, LPG, or PDS, what the government calls it, I would like to put it under the category of subsidies. The third category I would like to call it is incentive-based, where you have a social objective attached to it. Let us say you want to improve the gender ratio, you want to achieve certain specific IMR or MMR objectives, and you have a link to that. So I would like to look into this cash transfer mechanism into three categories. I repeat, one is contingency, second is subsidy, and third one is incentive towards the social objective. Now, I would like to look at reasons why it won't work in Indian context. The first reason I would like to say is targeting. 2 minutes, sir.
2 minutes.
Okay, targeting. Friends, 46% of rural debt is spent on only consumption. It is not spent on any particular investment. Now, if you look at this,